Morning, guys. It's day 8. I'm not sure what the date is. 18th, 19th, 20th, I have no idea. Day 8 of the attempt. Just finished up my zero. My legs feel great. Well, they feel better. Not great, better. And it's early. It's about 5:15 a.m. And I just couldn't sleep. I was just really antsy to get back on the trail. So, time to get to work. I have a 2-mile road walk to get back to the trail. So that's kind of a bummer, but I'm super excited. Real quick, I wanted to mention something to you guys. I mentioned earlier in one of my earlier videos that I have like checkpoints, like different parts along the trail that are important. So recently I crossed that 100-mile invisible line. And I have a certain amount of those throughout the trail, but I also have 3 goals that are just kind of lofty, and I really don't care too much if I don't hit them, because safety is most important and I want to finish this hike. But I wanted to mention them to you so you could celebrate with me if I do them, right? Yes. So here are the 3 goals. 1 is something called 10 by 10. 10 by 10 is hiker lingo for completing 10 miles before 10 a.m. Okay, that's the first goal. 2nd is a 30, just means 30-mile day. I got really close to doing that. On that day where I was crossing underneath I-5, I did 26.5, but it was like a torrential downpour. I was at the bottom of a hill and it was like a mudslide. And I was like, there's no way I'm doing this at night. So had to stop, could have easily done 30, but I think I can accomplish that. And then the last one, number 3, what is number 3? Oh yes, number 3 is called the 24-hour challenge. And that one I really highly doubt. This doesn't sound very much fun, hiking in the dark, but it may happen. Maybe on one of the flat sections, I'll get after it. So obviously you could do all 3 of those at the same time, but there's no way I'm doing that. So anyways, the reason I mentioned those 3 goals to you today is because it's 5:15 and it should be a pretty easy day for me to do a 10 by 10. Woo! So anyways, we'll see at the end of the day if I did it or not. So again, recap, heading north in a north direction all day. Good stuff, right? Heading home. Actually, the PCT is finally heading north after heading east for a long, long, long time. So super excited about that. I should start covering ground back towards home. So miss you guys. Hope everyone's doing good, staying healthy. You guys, go out and win the day, okay? Go do something cool, go do something awesome for your parents, go do something worthwhile. Don't just play Fortnite. Get your body moving and go win the day. Love you all. See you guys later. Did I tell you the bugs are getting bad? They're getting bad. They're big, they're huge, they're prehistoric, they're massive. That's all right. pulled out the head net. Again, fashionista, baby. Bloodsuckers aren't gonna get me. Alright, let's get back on trail. Alright, guys, it's 10 a.m. and I got 11.8 miles on the PCT this morning. Can I get a what? Huh? Can I get a Can I get a shout out for Mr. Teeter? Woo! Huh? That's a check. That's a boom. 10 by 10. But I also like you to know that was 11.8 miles. But I also have 2 mile road walk. So not to brag or anything, but I just did 13.8 miles before 10. I'm pretty stoked. Flying pretty high right now. So super cool. Alright guys, check this out. Tell me that's beautiful. Whoa! Oh! It's amazing. There's a lake down there. That washout's pretty gnarly, but you know what? I'm making sure I have 3 points of contact except for when I'm filming right now. Got my spikes on and I'm right here on top of a talus field, so I know exactly what's underneath me. But I wanted to stop and let you guys know, or let you guys see what I'm seeing. It's absolutely freaking gorgeous. Anyway, it's time for me to hike on. I'll see you guys later. Waymaker. Song I was listening to, the worship song, as I'm walking through this forest of dry bones. There's an amazing worship song called Waymaker. I'm gonna cry just thinking of it. The way God is speaking to me out here, Megan, it's ridiculous. Friends, family, the way that God is speaking to me out here is ridiculous. We serve a Waymaker. We serve a God who knows what's going on. When life seems so terrible, you can't breathe, he's making a way. He's making a way. And you have no idea what's on the other side of this mountain. You have no idea what's on the other side of this field of dry bones. We serve an amazing God. God, you're so good. I mean, just look at this, friends. I mean, this is just absolutely amazing. This year was rough, right? I mean, we had COVID, we still have COVID. We're still dealing with that. I mean, I have to wear my mask every time I see somebody on the trail. When we had that, we had just a realization of systemic racism. Had family members get sick and die. It's been a year, right? I know it's so hard to believe that God's making a way that makes sense. Just another freaking tree blown down in the way.
but it will make sense. I have faith that it will make sense someday. I'm on the other side. God has something better. He wants to teach us through this. God never promised us a life of ease, but He did promise. He did promise that He'd be with us through the crap. Right? I mean, like, He promised that. And surely I will be with you to the end of the age. And we serve a God that's not like... We serve a God who knows what it's like to be human. Not like subjectively, but experientially, He knows what it's like to be human. He knows what it's like to be humiliated. He knows what it's like to lose friends, to be backstabbed. He knows what it's like to be sick, to see friends die. So that gives me faith. Gives me hope. Gosh, I'm a mess. I'm sorry, guys. May you, my brothers and sisters, may you understand that there is a God out there who makes ways. Who makes a way out of seemingly stuff that's seemingly dead and dry. He makes paths. He brings forgiveness and hope and love. You just have to reach out and take it. You just have to reach out and take it. May you not miss that. When you feel like you're in a forest of dry bones. When you feel like you're in a forest like this. Everything's dry, dead. May you remember that there's a God who's making a way. Trust that. And know that He has experienced what it's like to be human.
Stop.